Hi folks, it's Wednesday again, which means I've got another video for you. To be honest, today I was going to be a little self-serving. All I kind of really wanted to do was ramble for a bit about the post-issue release blues that I've got. It's a pretty typical thing that happens whenever I release a new issue of the magazine, and I kind of end up feeling like, you know, it didn't get as far in social media as I would like. And obviously, there's a million reasons for that, and obsessing over social media and stats and analytics and everything isn't the way I want to spend my days, but I do that for about a week or so after a new issue is released. Of course, with the current president that is in the United States, it's hard to ignore things that are going on there while checking out social media, and it's also kind of hard to break through that. So, I don't know, I guess today I'm feeling kind of conflicted with the fact that I wish it was easier to get things out in front of people online, but I also think it's important that people talk about things like Trump's policy to, you know, rip children away from families when they're trying to get across the border. I just don't know, I feel like we should try, there should be a balance, and right now my Facebook feed is nothing but that story, which, like I said, should be talked about, but on the other side of someone trying to run a business, you know, I'm trying to figure out how to get people to engage with things, and over the last while, what seems to be things that people will engage with are things that either make them angry or really sad. So I can talk about Ricky Gervais making a transphobic joke, and people will come out in droves. I can talk about, you know, Lush fat shaming, and people come out to defend them. But I talk about something related to the magazine, and I mean, it's been okay, but it hasn't been near that status. And so I don't know, I feel like there's something wrong with the way that social media works and the way that it's kind of trained us, because, you know, if you like something, you just hit that little button, but if something pisses you off or really makes you upset, you get more involved, and that involvement is what really pushes things out in front of people, and that is why Trump has dominated the media for more than a year now, and that's why he also pushes the things he does, you know, like making the football protests a big thing when he should be talking about other things, or, you know, doing these big ridiculous gestures to get attention, and it feeds people into it, and that's all they talk about when, you know, there's all these other policies going on, or the government is slowly but surely removing, like, pages from their health website and everything else about, like, LGBTQ2SIA+ people and everything. And no one's really talking about that, because everyone's talking about, you know, Trump and the latest ridiculous thing he said. Which we should be talking about, but should it dominate the landscape that we're in? Should we somehow talk about other things as well? I feel like we should. I feel like maybe in the past we did, but right now it seems like the only stuff that gets coverage is the really over-the-top things. And I don't know, are there ways to fight that? Should we be fighting it while also fighting those ridiculous things? Kind of feel like we should. I don't really have an answer. Maybe I'm asking the question, looking for answers from you. Either way, I guess, as always, I appreciate you watching this and giving me the time to listen to my rambles, because like I've been saying, not everybody does. So I hope you're having a good evening, a good day, a good night, and good morning wherever you are. I'll see you again next week.